It unfortunately seems like most of the Legends EA related leaks are probably going to be coming to an end here pretty soon, because the leaker stated that he doesn't really want to release anything more about Legends EA just in case the Pokemon company or Game Freak decides to delay the game. Because in reality, they could delay the game, you know what I mean? Like, they could seal the leak, and if there's too much information out there like relating to Legends EA, they could definitely delay the game and change things, which would obviously be unfortunate. And we already know that they have already delayed the game once. Like, it was like a soft delay, like we never knew about it, because in some of the files that were leaked, it basically was saying that Legends EA was supposed to be planned, was supposed to be released in 2024. Like, its planned release was 2024, and obviously that didn't happen, and we didn't even get the announcement until early 2024. So it's almost 2025, and the game's obviously coming out 2025. The trailer said it's gonna come out in 2025, so without a doubt, it's coming out next year, and we're gonna get to like the release date schedule, I guess, here shortly. So these are all of the Legends EA leaks and details as of right now. There could be more in the future, who knows? I'm really hoping we get some more. I don't really want to see like any leaked photos or gameplay though. Like, I honestly just want to know some like random stuff, you know what I mean? For example, Stunfisk is in the game. That's something that we know. It's like, why do we need to know that? There's probably no reason for that, but it's kind of interesting to know that, you know what I mean? I want to see more stuff like that. Right before we get into that though, make sure to subscribe to the channel, leave a like, and comment down below what you want to see in Legends EA. Any support goes a long way, I really appreciate it. So the first one is the most obvious one, we knew this from the trailer. It takes place completely within Lumio City, and I also think that the Pokemon like website even stated this specifically when the trailer dropped. So the game is taking place in Lumio City, which basically means like the scale of everything is going to be, you know, lifelike, I guess I'll say, because with the traditional Pokemon game, you know, cities are not really that big. It's a couple of buildings, maybe, you know what I mean? Like, it's a couple of buildings, and the scale is not really there. It's not really, like, a life-size scale, I guess. So, with Lumio City, it's gonna look a lot like the Brilliant Diamond, Shining Pearl concept art, where, you know, you're a trainer, obviously you're a trainer, walking right through the city, right through the buildings, and the buildings in the city is like an actual city as you would walk through in real life. So a lot of people are really concerned about that. I would be lying if I said I wasn't concerned either, because I definitely am a little concerned about that. But however, I do think it's going to be fun. Like, I do think this is going to be a nice way to kind of change the typical Pokemon game a little bit. The last couple of Pokemon games have been extremely experimental, and Legends EA is no different. If it's taking place entirely within the city, that's totally different than any Pokemon game we've ever had. And reportedly, we're not getting any, like, wildlife areas outside of Lumio City, which is interesting. That's very concerning, but I think that with the map, there are these giant circles, and I think those are going to be, like, wildlife areas within Lumio City. So, obviously, if they're planning on this, they're definitely going to give us a way to hunt and, you know, wild Pokemon, and it's gonna make sense. Like, when the game comes out, we get some more gameplay footage, like, officially announced or released gameplay footage, it's gonna make sense, you know what I mean? Like, it's gonna be a good game. Game Freak 100% knows how the fans feel because of Scarlet and Violet, and that's why they delayed it. Like, it was supposed to be 2024, now it's coming out 2025. It's gonna be developed for the Switch 1, not the Switch 2, which, like I said in, like, probably 10 more, like, which I've said in probably 10 or more videos of mine, I really thought this game was gonna be released on the Switch 2, but I guess it's not. So hopefully the Switch 2 is backwards compatible. I'm hoping it will be. I'm pretty sure it is. I think the Switch 2 leaks were suggesting that it will be backwards compatible with the Switch 1, which would make sense. But this is coming out on the Switch 1. So I was thinking that we were going to get another Legends EA trailer right after they announced the Switch 2. I hope we get a Legends EA trailer, like, really soon. We better get one within the next 2 months. Like, I would love to see a trailer before the end of the year. And of course, new Megas are going to be introduced. This one was obvious from the initial trailer, but with the Terra leak that went down, we know that we're going to get Mega Zygarde, Mega Zeraora, and others. We don't know any others as of right now, I don't think. Those are the only two that, like, are officially, unofficially in the game. And by officially, unofficially, I mean because it was in the leaks. You know what I mean? And leaks are subject to change because the game is not officially out yet. The shiny sparkle sound from Legends Arceus is back, which is amazing. I love that so much. So if you don't know what that is, basically in Legends Arceus, when a shiny Pokemon would spawn in, it would play a shiny sparkle noise, whereas in Scarlet and Violet, if a shiny Pokemon spawned in, you just had to visually see it. Like, it didn't make a charm, it didn't make a sparkle noise. So I like that a lot because it makes it a lot easier for sure. And I don't know how most people feel about this, but I think it's fun. I think that's great. And I'm definitely going to be shiny hunting, because I shiny hunted a lot in Scarlet and Violet, and I actually found a pretty good amount of shinies. I didn't take it, like, too seriously, though. Like, I was just kind of casually doing it just for a couple of Pokemon that I wanted on my team. But, man, the YouTubers that make shiny hunting videos are next level. They put some time, they put some serious time into that, and I really enjoy watching shiny hunting videos because those are just so entertaining. It's like a real sport, you know what I mean? Like, there's so much behind shiny hunting and being the most efficient with shiny hunting that it's incredible. It's crazy. Unlike Legends Arceus, the game is not set in the past, so basically, the game is probably going to be set either after the events of X and Y or like relatively before, like still in the modern era, but before X and Y. My early theory, like when I first saw the trailer, I really thought it was going to take place in the past and the future. And then I was starting to think it was going to be in the future just because the blueprints kind of looked a little futuristic and it says redevelopment plan. So, you know, obviously the word redevelopment means like you're redoing it and the city was already there. So, I don't know. I'm sure it's probably going to take place after X and Y, which I think is going to be interesting for so many reasons. And like, I'll just mention a couple. Maybe I can make a whole other video about this. What are the starter Pokemon going to be? Because if it's a Legends game, if we're going to take inspiration from Legends Arceus, you know, that didn't use the traditional Generation 4 starters. Like, it used a range of three different generational Pokemon starters. So it's like, it's another Legends game. Is it going to be the Gen 6 starter Pokemon, or is it going to be three random Pokemon? You know what I mean? I would say that's my number one concern with this game, or like wonder. It's like, what are the starters gonna be? Because I just don't know how they would not make it the Gen 6 starters, because it's literally in Lumio City, which is, you know, Generation 6. That's the Kalos region. So that's pretty interesting to me. Art style is similar to Scarlet and Violet, and that doesn't necessarily mean like all the graphics. It kind of just means like the art style, I guess. That's kind of how I'm taking it. I guess it could mean the graphics. I really don't know. There's no more specification behind this, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it could be the graphics, and I'm really hoping it looks better than Scarlet and Violet. Legends Arceus was great. Legends Arceus looked great to me. Scarlet and Violet, like, they still looked good, but they, for like what the game is, like for being a Pokemon game, the highest, the biggest franchise of all time, it was subpar. It was not what anyone was really looking for. So I'm really hoping that the graphics are at least a little better. And by art style, the way I'm taking that is like the pastel, like watercolor vibe going on with Scarlet and Violet. That's kind of what I'm thinking. And unfortunately, apparently the game has performance issues like Scarlet and Violet, which I'm hoping that's because the game was played through a PC, like an emulated kind of thing where like they're just using the files on their computer and they're not actually playing it on the Switch. I'm really hoping the game does not have performance issues. I can't imagine them releasing another game with performance issues. To me, that is crazy. I honestly really think that they're gonna release the game polished. Like, I can't imagine them giving us an unpolished, like, performance issued full game. I can't imagine that, and I'm really hoping not. Mabel from Team Flare is in the game, part of the Quasar organization somehow. That's interesting. I don't really have much to say about that, but maybe that could be some of the connection, like the bridge from, you know, the past, I guess. Who knows? In 2024, current release date is between April and July 2025, unless there's another delay, and then Stunfisk is in the game. So apparently the game is going to be released like kind of mid-ish 2025, like a little bit before mid-2025. Hopefully there's no delay. Let me know what you're thinking about Legends EA. I think it's going to be a good game. Like, I'm honestly, I'm super optimistic. I don't want to sound like I'm being too cheerful, but I'm very optimistic, and I think it's going to be a polished game, and I really think they're focusing on it just because all the other news about Game Freak, you know, hiring different companies, making new companies, whatever. I think they're really trying to lock in and focus on building a better Pokemon game that's in the 3D world, at least, because the 3D Pokemon games have been all so different from each other. So I think they're just trying to find like where they are best in, and I think it's going to be a good game. So make sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys next time.